Welcome to The Laboratory, a video series brought to you by Miracles Innovation Labs.
Hi, and welcome to The Laboratory video series brought to you by Miracles Innovation Labs. My name is Krishna Reddy, and I am the part of the innovation team in Miracles Software Systems. In this video, I am going to talk about robotics and Amigo functionalities and some of the cognitive services. Our agenda is what is the robotics and what is the use of the robotics, where we are using the robotics, and what are the main things for the robotics and Amigo functionalities, and end up with a quick demo. Robotics is a branch of engineering and science that includes the mechanical engineering, electrical engineering, and computer science, and a lot more. Robotics deals with the design, construction, and operation. We need few main things for robotics. Those are the processor, sensor, and actuators. Processors are used to process the data which is coming from the sensors and give back the data to the actuators to perform the real actions. Robotics are used as the substitutes for humans in few cases, like military, regular works, bomb disposals, bomb detection, and etc. Humanoid robots replicate walking, lifting, speech, cognitive, and basically anything a human can do. Robotics used in a STEM like science, technology, engineering, and mathematics as a technical aid. The main three laws of the robotics are: the first law is the robots must never harm for the human beings. The second law is robots must follow instructions from the humans without violating the first law. Finally, the third law is robots must protect themselves without violating the other two rules. The main applications includes for the robotics are military robots, cleaning robots, hospital robots, agricultural robots, and nano robots. A servo motor is a closed loop servo mechanism that uses the position feedback to control its motion and final position to inputs. Its control is a signal command. Like the servo motors, we have the PWM, pulse width modulation. It is the process of turning on and off digital voltage quickly to simulate a range of voltage. The heart of the servo is a small direct current motor. We have three types of the servo motors. The first one is the positional rotation servo. It rotates in about a half of a circle, like 180 degrees. It has in the physical stops placed in the gear mechanism to prevent turning behind these limits to protect the rotational sensors. These found in the robotic arms, legs, and the head. We have the second one is the continuous rotation servo. It is same as the positional rotation servo, except it can turn in either directions indefinitely, like in clockwise and anti-clockwise as desired at varying speeds, depending on the command signal. Finally, the linear servo. It will move back and forth, except these everything is same as the positional rotation servo and continuous rotation servo. So we have the Amigo functionalities. The brain of the Amigo is a EasyBV4. It is easily programmed over Wi-Fi from easy builder software from laptops, PCs, tablets, and mobile phones. It is having a 32-bit CPUs at 200 MHz. One is the ARM Cortex-M3 and another one is the microchip PIC32. It is having an energy efficient digital switching power supply, and it is having a Wi-Fi module, and it is having a audio output. We have a 3 I2C ports, 3 UART pins, 24 I/O pins, digital pins for input and output. We can communicate these through these digital pins. We can have the capability to connect to the 73 servo motors at a time. We have 8 analog pins. All these signals having a 3 pins. One is the ground, one is the VCC, and one is the signal. So Amigo is like a human in structure. We can talk with Amigo, it will walk and speak with us. To communicate with Amigo, we need to write some coding, but it is not like our normal code like a C, Java, Python. It is as simple as child can write it and play with the Amigo. RoboScratch is developed by the EZ robot community to communicate with the Amigo. And one more program is the Blockly. It is developed by the Google, and mainly every robots are the capability to communicate with these scripts. It is using a EZ script to control the robot. It is having so many predefined functionalities like speech recognition, dance, and few actions like wave, push-ups, pick up the object, and so on. We can install so many third-party plugins like cognitive services, those are the vision, emotion, speech, speech-to-text, text-to-speech, and API.ai. It is having the capability to communicate with third-party robots like PE remotes, Sparrow, and Mayo. We can connect ultrasonic sensors to it and measure the distance between the objects and the robot. The working process. We can communicate with the laptops, mobile, tablets, and PCs to humanoid robot through the Wi-Fi. Amigo provides with a Wi-Fi connectivity, and through that we are controlling the robot. For communicating with the third-party services which are in the cloud, we need the network. For that, we are sending the request and get back the response from that services. And this is the quick live demo. Here is the Amigo. We can access the Amigo with the voice control. Hi, Amigo. Amigo, move forward. Amigo, stop. Amigo, move reverse. Amigo, stop. Amigo, turn left. Amigo, turn left. So we can compose the songs also. Amigo will sing the songs and dance also. So I play the song. We can integrate Amigo with Microsoft Cognitive Services. I will check with the Microsoft Services. So I will check with the Microsoft Cognitive Emotion Service.
I think a man standing in a room.
So Amigo will say the emotions also. I will test with it.
I think you are looking happiness.
Thank you.
Thank you for watching The Laboratory, a video series brought to you by Miracles Innovation Labs. For more on innovation, please visit miraclesoft.com/thelabs.